Hi friends, welcome to Java interview questions. So in this video we'll see an important Java interview question: what is immutable class? So this is one of the famous interview question as for both freshers as well as experienced developers. So we'll see what is an immutable class. First we'll understand or we'll define what is an immutable class. So immutable classes are those classes whose object cannot be modified once created. So the definition is, object cannot be modified once created. So objects or instances of a class cannot be modified once they are created. So any modification on immutable object should result in a new object. Okay. So if you are trying to modify an object of an immutable class, it should create a new object rather than modifying the existing object. For example, if we take instance of a string class, so string is an immutable. Any wrapper class if you take in Java are immutable. Okay, like integer, string, and all those immutable classes. So since string is an immutable class, any change on the existing string object will result in another string. Suppose if you are trying to replacing a character in the string, creating a substring from a string, it will create a new string. If you are replacing a character in the string, it will not modify the existing string. It will create a new string. Okay. And the existing reference will point to the new string. So in case of mutable objects, if we take right string buffer, any modification is done on the object itself and no objects will be created. No new objects will be created if you take any mutable object. Example, string buffer, string builder, and all those. So hope you understand what is an immutable class, and we will see how to write an immutable class in Java, or we can say as set of rules how to write immutable class in Java. So if you have to write an immutable class in Java, first thing what we need to do is, state of immutable objects cannot be modified after construction. Okay. So that is, any modification should result in new immutable object. So, I mean, we have few rules, okay, to write an immutable class in Java. First one is, don't provide any methods that modify the object state. So the first one is, don't provide any methods that modify the object state. We should not provide any methods which modifies the state of an object. So mostly try to provide only getter methods. Okay. And the second one is, all the fields of immutable class should be final. All fields of immutable class should be final. So all the properties or all the fields or the variables defined in immutable class should be final. And third point is, the class cannot be extended. The class cannot be extended. How do we make sure we cannot extend a class? By defining a class with, okay, by defining a class with final, okay, we cannot extend that class. Next, make all fields as private. We should make all the fields of a class as private. So what happens is, if we make all the fields as private, this prevents clients from obtaining access to the mutable objects, refer to the fields, and modifying these objects directly. Okay. Next, ensure exclusive access to any mutable components. So if your class has any fields that refer to a mutable object, ensure that clients of the class cannot obtain reference to this object. Okay, if your class has any fields that refer to the mutable object, make sure that clients of the class cannot obtain reference to this object. So these are the five rules, which important rules to make or to write an immutable class in Java. Now we'll write a program to see how to write an immutable class in Java. I have created an immutable class and I'm writing a main method inside it. Sorry, don't write main method. I will show you after that. So first thing is, whenever we are writing an immutable class, make sure the class cannot be extended. So just say this class as final. Define this class with final modifier. And then suppose I am taking some variables. String private final string, and I'm naming that variable as name. Okay, and then private final string, I'm declaring one more variable as value. Okay, private final string name and the value. So the thing is, the plan final field name may not have been initialized. Okay, just try to initialize these variables with some values. So we need to initialize these values. We cannot give final field like this. So I'm just initializing it with empty, and here also I'm initializing it with empty. Now create a constructor for this class. Public immutable class and get the value of name and value using this constructor, and I am saying this dot name equal to name, this dot value equal to value. Okay, let's see what is the compilation in here. So actually we need to initialize the final variables. So that is the reason, for the time being, to fix the compilation error, I have made this as empty. Now we should not have this, because the only way to initialize these variables is through constructor. So that is the reason I am saying public immutable class string name string value, this dot name equal to name, this dot value equal to value, and provide the getter methods for this name and value. And I am saying get name. Okay, and then get value. See how simple it is. So if you see here, whenever we create an object of this class, okay, at that time only we can give the values to this name and value. We cannot modify the state of this object, that is name and value, okay, by any of the means. Why? Because these are final, and the only way to initialize them is by using this. And we don't even have any setter methods to modify the name and value. So we should not define any getters and setters, sorry, any setter methods in order to modify the object. That we have done. So don't provide any methods that modify the object state. This is done. All the fields of immutable class should be final. Okay, we have given all the, we have declared all the fields as final, and the class cannot be extended. So that is the reason. So in order to avoid the class extending, what we need to do, we need to declare that class as final. We have done that. So this is how we define an immutable class. So now whenever we create an immutable class for this, whenever we create an object, every time it creates a new object, and it cannot be modified after the construction. Okay. Hope you understand this video and how to write an immutable class. Thanks for watching this video. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel.